An early autumn dawn breaks. Gentle, shimmering rays of light begins to fall upon the cold waters of Indus River. In a distance, waves of water slices away, giving path to the fisherman's boat. The net slowly submerges, finding its way to the bottom of the water, while the rudder gives the direction to the nearest shore. With so much areas to cover, the men are busy with their usual routine of laying down the fishing nets. Just as the light touches the surface of this cold water, mist rises up to dance, giving a mesmerizing sight of nature play. The gentlest breeze flows down the still water, creating endless ripples, swaying the wooden body sideways in synchronized harmony. As the sun slowly comes on the top of the horizon, the fog scatters the light between the water and the sky to give heartwarming glow to the surroundings. A mirage display of the water with resting boats comes to sight. As the day rises, flocks of little egret move in for their early hunt, and little robin welcomes the fishermen in their boats. The sheds of light and shadow through the trees in the clear waters give serenity to the entire atmosphere. with so much beauty to sit and stare for the visitors. Duty calls for the farmers here. Tourism is one of the major occupations of the Markhu and Kulekhani residents. Pisciculture and boating industry has been coherent business for the residents living near Indra Sarovar. The fish here are bred through offshore cultivation method or cage system. It allows containing and protecting the fishes until they can be harvested. Some of the fishes found in the lake are Biket, silver carp, nauri, copper mashir, grass carp, and snow trout. A fishery development board has been established under Fishery Commercial Private Limited, comprising of 700 shareholders, for a systematic operation of the farming. The total remuneration collected primarily is deposited under this company. The 114-meter tall Kulekhani Dam creates Indra Sarovar, a 7-kilometer long, 420-feet deep, 25-kilometer wide reservoir, which holds approximately of 69,200 acre-feet of water. The construction of the dam began in 1977, and Kulekhani 1 was commissioned in 1982. Which generated 60 megawatt of hydroelectric power. Kulekhani 2 was commissioned in 1986 and provides 32 megawatt, and the third power station is Kulekhani 3, provides 14 megawatt electricity. It is the largest man-made lake in Nepal. It lies at the deep gorge between Markhu and Kulekhani VDC and operates under the authority of Nepal Electricity Corporation. Markhu is the small town to the northwestern shore of Indra Sarovar. Markhu VDC is located in province number 3 of Markhu Makwanpur District, Nepal. Increasing local tourism encourages people to visit this place of eccentric beauty. It is 42 kilometers from Balkhu 7 km from Dakshinkali Kalangi Dam site and approximately 14 km from Chandragiri Hill via Chitlang. A boat commercial private limited has also been established with currently 400 shareholders. It provides organized conduction of the services and assures economic and operational security to the local boatmen. Around 20 boats are into current operation for recreational use as well as for daily operational use by the locals. Blessed with mesmerizing natural beauty of greenery, lakes, mountain range, and ethnic culture and religious sites, Markhu has been an ideal spot for amateur and professional video shooting. The entry fee for shooting unit can range from 500 to 1000 Nepali rupees. The fund is collected by the local community club and is used for the village development programs and activities. Only a few hours away from the capital, it serves a great escape from the reality. Markhu has a history of being gateway route to automobile history of Nepal. The first vehicle brought to Nepal was probably during the 1900s. In 1939, Adolf Hitler gifted Mercedes-Benz to then Rana Prime Minister as a gift, which was carried through Bhimphedi Kulekhani, Chitlang to Kathmandu. During the Rana regime, Markhu was a resting place for the elites before entering the valley. Bhim Samshir Rana built a palace to his name during his regime, which now is under possession of Nepal Electricity Authority. Markhu has a population of approximately 600 households, constituting heterogeneous ethnic community of 97% Tamang, 1-2% Brahmin, miscellaneous 1% Newar and Magar residences. Markhu is also ideal gateway for trekkers and adventurers who seek a quick getaway to nature, life, culture, adventure and serenity. From Markhu, Thankot can be reached via Chitlang. The Chandragiri-Laliguras trekking route is not presently into use connecting Daman, but are choices for solo trekkers. Adventurers seeking thrill can add Markhu to their wish list and seek memory of a lifetime.